So this is a RepRap discount full graphic smart controller. So these are, as it says right there, 128 by 64 pixel liquid crystal displays. And they also have on the back an SD card. And you've got your two connectors here, EXP1 and EXP2. And I got one of these with the Rumba board that I ordered, and I could not get this thing to work. And so I thought I might have a bad controller, so I thought, well, let's get a second one. And the second one does exactly the same thing. The push button on the rotary selector will make the screen beep and the backlight flashes on and off every once in a while, but it doesn't display anything. And the problem is, you can see the notch on the connector, and there's the notch on the silk screen, and you can see how this connector, I have the notch on the top. At the suggestion of one YouTube video I saw, they finally explained what was going on. So this silk screen is wrong. The connector number itself is correct. The silk screen showing the position of the notch is wrong. So let me show you how to swap those. It turns out it's not that hard. What you need to do is get some needle nose pliers, and you want to work on alternate ends here. You want to stay away from the pins because you don't want to bend the pins. And so you just get in here and you have to put your thumb kind of down on the circuit board because there's nothing supporting the circuit board here in the middle. So you got to kind of pull there and pull. Okay, you can see how I've got that connector up a little bit. It takes probably a couple of minutes because you can't pull it very far because the connector shell will rock on those pins. So yeah, here we go. Let's see if we can work a screwdriver in there just as a show you the connector shell moving there. Yeah, you can kind of work that in a little bit. I guess, yeah, that actually works pretty good. So you just want to go a little bit on one side, a little on the other side. So there we go. Got the connector shell right to the top. And then what you want to do is flip it over so the notch is up on the top. This is where you got to get all 10 pins back in the holes. Make sure they're all in there. And then you want to slowly push that back down. So there you go. You can see how I've got all the pins started. And then you're down. Flush back down there, so I got both notches to the top. And that way you don't have to modify your ribbon cables, because the ribbon cables have a little bump on them that has to fit into that notch. So this is the LCD connection. This is your SD. So the connector next to your SD slot is for the SD. And then this one, you can see all the traces come over here, and I guess that's where the controller for the LCD screen is. So let me go plug this in, and I'll bring you back with the Rumba controller, and we'll see if this thing works. Okay, here we go, YouTube. I burned the Marlin firmware into the Rumba board here, and this particular board does have the connector shells on it, and this one is labeled EXP1, that's EXP2. So on this board, the connectors are labeled correctly. That's EXP1, EXP2. Number 2 is closest to your SD card and plugs in over here. You've got the red line on the cable to this outside here, but I've got the notches on these connectors flipped over 180 degrees. So the notches are on the top of the board as you look at it. So I've got a 12 volt lithium battery over here for power. Now if you watch right here, there's an LED right next to this connector. And if you watch that, when I turn on the power, that's showing that it's communicating to the liquid crystal display. So that works. One thing I'm gonna have to do is the dial here is backwards, because normally if you turn it clockwise, it'll go down. This one you turn counterclockwise. So I guess I've got to switch that. And then it looks like the SD card is not responding there. Yeah, I don't have the SD menu. I must not have compiled that in there. So do fan speed. Yeah, you can see if I go clockwise, the number doesn't increment. If I go counterclockwise, it does. So let's see, here's my parts cooling fan. Yeah, there we go. You can see the fan's running. I can turn it down to zero and it goes off. So now I got to work on getting the SD card working. But yeah, that is the problem. The silk screen shows the connector shells installed incorrectly. So you got to flip those over and that gets working there. But yeah, that with the full graphics shows your fan, shows your bed temperature, and then I guess that's the extruder temperature. And you've got your XYZ coordinate, and then this would be the where the SD card. So I still need to get that working. So in the Marlin configuration.h file, there's a definition for RepRap discount full graphics smart controller, and you have to enable that or uncomment that particular definition, and then it'll compile in all that code. And it looks like it's pretty much working. I got a few details to work out there. Actually ended up with two of these controllers because I thought the first one was bad. So I picked up a second one, had the exact same problem. I found a few notes that kept saying the connectors were wrong, and some of them said these two are swapped. So they'll say this is EXP1, that is EXP2. But on this board, I confirmed that this was the graphics or the LCD connector. These two are the same. The numbers line up, but the pin assignments don't. So your red wires are to the side that the SD is on, not to the other side. Kind of decoded all the various comments. You find dozens of comments. You know, some people, oh, mine worked fine. Mine doesn't work. I tried this. There was one guy that said he shorted a couple of these pins together and got it working. Somebody else said they flexed the circuit board, because I guess some of these interconnect pins here go through connectors, like a pin header and a header connector. The two boards I have are all soldered. I looked at them under a magnifying glass and couldn't see any obviously bad solder joints, and I tried flexing the two boards and doing a bunch of stuff. Nothing seemed to help, but anyway, we got that working. Mostly, I got a few little tweaks to do to it. Yeah, I'll need to look at how this one works versus how the 20x4 alphanumeric display works. See which one is better, if there's any advantages. I know the other one, it's a bigger display, but then this one, they can pack more information in with graphics rather than numbers. Because you pretty much get the same thing, though. There was RUMBA ready. You had this SD card percentage, you had your XYZ, and then you had your temperatures up there on the top. So four lines. I guess all their menus are set up for four lines anyway. Just you get a little nicer looking menu, you know, with pictures rather than text. But yeah, thought I'd show you that working. Looks like it's all up and running. I've got something working now. That's the important part. So I got to get the SD working. I got to get the direction and the sensitivity set up there and get the rest of things going. But other than that, I think it looks pretty good. Thought I'd show you the full graphic smart controller running there. That's the way to get that working. Switch your cables around. So yeah, if you have any questions about that, post up in the comment section below, and I'll put any future follow-up videos over on the left side. And as always, thanks for watching.